For Luke Bryan and Blake Shelton, you can't teach an old country bro new tricks. As the men of country music have gone from despicable to gentlemanly, the sound of the genre has begun to change as well. The songs are getting leaner and less imaginative, and the genre's recent flirtations with hip-hop and pop have been receding in favor of more straightforward arrangements. The shifts have been relatively quick, leaving the elders of the bro country movement seeking relevance in a changed landscape. Texoma Shore is Blake Shelton's 11th album since 2001, and What Makes You Country is Luke Bryan's 6th since 2007. They are genre superstars staring down their twilight. They are not quite ready to reflect. Texoma Shore is autopilot Shelton, amiable, rapscallionish, but with a few concessions to the current moment, in which oafs have brushed their hair, shaved their scruff and tried to make right. The Genie Lyle Name the Dogs, one of his best singles in years, paints him as not just redeemable but also redeemed, albeit with the familiar gender politics. You plant the flowers, I'll plant the kisses. Mr. Shelton is a reassuring singer, with deep southern contours to his voice, and he relies on them more than he does his melodies. He's more of a convincer than a crooner. His world is generally binary. He often returns to the "you're like this, I'm like that" song construction, in which women are flawless and men are reprehensible at the core, but not without hope. You were diamonds in the sky, I was dirt on a plow / you're all American pretty, I'm a one-horse town, he sings on the numbingly plaintive "why me." Since Mr. Shelton rarely varies his tone or his arrangements, Texoma Shore has the feel of a playlist, overly cautious about disrupting its mood and pace. Money, about growing up poor, is something of a country rap song, but nowhere near the accomplishment that was Boys Round Here. His sassy 2013 hit, one of the signature songs of that sound. But Mr. Shelton, despite earlier experiments, isn't truly interested in genre progressivism. He's a classicist gripping a fifth of whiskey, happily watching everyone around him scramble. For a time in the late 2000s and early 2010s, Mr. Bryan was one of those scramblers, a country maximalist with songs about souped-up trucks and gyrating rear ends. But he, too, is reverting to simplicity now. What Makes You Country is among his most temperate albums, alternately soothing and fatiguing. Perhaps because his voice is more genre-neutral than Mr. Shelton's, Mr. Bryan, who sings with some soul music inflections, is emphatic about his rural signifiers. He uses What Makes You Country, the title track, to shore up his bona fides. I got my dirt road cred when I was 12 / on a no-cab tractor haulin' them bales. And there is Hooked on It, a whole song about fishing that is nowhere near as clever as Brad Paisley's I'm Gonna Miss Her, the fishing song. It is not insignificant, amid all this, that he makes room for tolerance. I believe you love who you love / ain't nothing you should ever be ashamed of, he sings on Most People Are Good, in what qualifies as a bold embrace, for country music, of accepting sexual orientation diversity, recalling Casey Musgraves's conversation starter Follow Your Arrow. Mr. Shelton has a writing credit on one of the 11 songs on Texoma Shore. Mr. Bryan wrote on 7 of the 15 on What Makes You Country, though not Most People Are Good. Note that Mr. Bryan's album title isn't a question, as an early synthesizer of styles during an era when the genre was actively grappling with identity. Mr. Bryan has been making the case for Big Ten country music for years. But What Makes You Country is a step backward, a fusillative trite cliché. I believe most people are good and most mamas ought to qualify for sainthood. I believe most Friday nights look better under neon or stadium lights, he sings on Most People Are Good, which apart from its moment of inclusiveness is full of familiar small-town pride. Mr. Bryan is better as a sensualist. Lighted Up has the skittish pulse of a frayed relationship, and he's at his most emotionally tactile on Like You Say You Do, about coveting a woman his friend is letting down. By comparison, his songs about slow living feel rote. Mr. Shelton, however, isn't troubled by the same anxieties. Rather than belabor his qualifications, he just injects country attitude into his songs about other things. The sound around him, and the stars who make it, might change, but he never will.